Hello all. Today we are going to discuss Porter's model of generic strategies for competitive advantage. Now, what is competitive advantage? Let me take an analogy here. Which do you prefer when you fly? A cheap, no-frills airline or a more expensive operator with fantastic service levels and maximum comfort? And would you ever consider a small company with just a few routes? The choice is up to you. But the point I'm making here is that when you come to book a flight, there are some very different options available. Why is this so? The answer is that each of these airlines has chosen a different way of achieving competitive advantage in a crowded marketplace. So, Porter actually tells about a company's strategy to gain competitive advantage. Porter suggested four generic business strategies that could be adopted in order to gain competitive advantage. The strategies relate to the extent to which the scope of a business activities are narrow versus broad and the extent to which a business seeks to differentiate its products. Now, what is competitive advantage? A competitive advantage is an advantage over competitors gained by offering consumers greater value either by means of lower prices or by providing greater benefits and service that justifies higher prices. So in our example, the no-frills operators have opted to cut costs to a minimum and pass their savings on to the customers in lower prices. This helps them grab market share and ensure their planes are as full as possible. The luxury airlines, on the other hand, focuses their efforts on making their service as wonderful as possible, and the higher prices they can command as a result of making up it as an experience. Now, meanwhile, smaller airlines try to make the most of their detailed knowledge of just a few routes to provide better or cheaper services than their larger international rivals. So, this is how everyone creates a competitive advantage in their industry. So, the key strategic challenges for most businesses to find a way of achieving a sustainable competitive advantage over the other competing products and firms in a market. According to Porter, there can be four kinds of strategies which a company can assume: cost leadership, cost focus, differentiation focus, and differentiation leadership. Broadly, if you will see, so there are just two generic strategies, differentiation and cost strategy. Either you can differentiate your product or you can lower your costs. So when you lower your costs in the broader spectrum, it is cost leadership. When you lower the cost in the narrow spectrum, then it is cost focus. When you differentiate in broader terms, then it is differentiation leadership. And when it is in narrow terms, it is differentiation focus. Let us see what all they are. Cost leadership. Now, what is cost leadership? Porter's generic strategies are ways of gaining competitive advantage. That is developing the edge that gets you the sale and takes it away from your competitors. So there are two main ways of achieving this within a cost leadership strategy. One, you increase the profits by reducing the costs while charging industry average prices, or increasing the market share by charging lower prices while still making a reasonable profit on each sale. Now, you've got to remember that cost leadership is about minimizing the cost to the organization of delivering products and services. The cost or price paid by customer is a separate issue, but you have to minimize your own costs, right? In this sense, in this strategy, the objective is to become the lowest cost producer, low cost to you, not the price you are charging to the customers. So the traditional method to achieve this objective is to produce on a large scale, which enables the business to exploit economies of scale. So one of the ways to have cost leadership is you get the economies of scale. Now, this strategy is usually associated with large scale business offering standard products with relatively little differentiation that are readily acceptable to the majority of customers. Occasionally, a low-cost leader will also discount its product to maximum sales, particularly if it has significant cost advantage over the competition, and doing so, it can further increase its market share. So, what is a strategy of cost leadership requires? It requires close cooperation between all the functional areas to be a lowest cost producer. So, you have to have high level of productivity, high capacity utilization, use of bargaining power to negotiate the lowest prices for production inputs, lean production method like just in time, effective use of technology. So your processes should be efficient, your technology should be up to the mark, your bargaining power with your suppliers should be good, you should have optimum capacity utilization, and you should produce more. All these things will lead to the cost leadership. So it is basically the cost leadership strategy is exactly that. It involves being the leader in terms of cost in your industry or market, and simply being amongst the lowest cost producers is not good enough, as you leave yourself wide open to attack by other low cost producers who may undercut your prices and therefore block your attempts to increase market share. So therefore, you need to be confident that you can achieve and maintain the number one position before choosing the cost leadership route. Companies that are successful in achieving cost leadership usually have very efficient logistics, a low cost base, and access to the capital needed for investment in technology, which can bring the costs down. So the greatest risk in pursuing a cost leadership strategy is that these sources of cost reduction are not unique to you, and that other competitors copy your cost reduction strategies. And that is why it is important to continuously find ways of reducing every cost. One successful way of doing this is by adopting Japanese philosophy, Kaizen philosophy, which says you have to have continuous improvement. So in the cost leadership, you have to have continuous improvement. So next is cost focus. What is cost focus? In cost focus, a firm seeks a cost advantage in its target segment. So here a business seeks a lower cost advantage in just one or a smaller number of market segments. It doesn't focus on the entire cost leadership, but it concentrates its efforts on one or more products in line, or one or more markets. So the product will be basic, perhaps a similar product to the higher priced and featured market leader, but acceptable to sufficient consumers. Such products are often called me toos. So there are certain kind of substitutes available to the higher versions or the more costly versions of things. So they come into the cost focus. Then differentiation focus. What is differentiation focus? In the differentiation focus strategy, a business aims to differentiate within just one or a small number of target market segments. The special customer needs of the segment mean that there are opportunities to provide products that are clearly different from competitors who may be targeting a broader group of customers. So the important issue for any business adopting this strategy is to ensure that customers really do have a different needs and wants. In other words, that there is a valid basis of differentiation. So the consumer, he perceives that differentiation, and that existing competitor products are not meeting those needs and wants. So differentiation focus is the classic niche marketing strategy. Many small businesses are able to establish themselves in a niche market segment using this strategy, achieving higher prices than an undifferentiated product through specialist expertise or other ways to add value for customers. There are many successful examples of differentiation focus. A good one is Terrell Crisps, which focus on smaller hand-fried premium segment of crisp industry. So it's a differentiation strategy. You need to have good research, development, innovation. In a differentiation, what is the differentiation? It involves making your product or services different from and more attractive than those of your competitors. And how do you do this depends on the exact nature of your industry and the products and services themselves. but will typically involve features for functionality, durability, support, and also brand image that your customers value. To make a successful differentiation strategy, organization need to have, of course, good research, development, innovation, and also the ability to deliver high quality products or services, as well as effective sales and marketing, so that the market understands the benefits offered by differentiated offerings. Large organizations pursuing a differentiation strategy need to stay very flexible with their new product development processes. Otherwise, what will happen? They'll risk attack on several fronts by competitors pursuing focused differentiation strategies. So, in this differentiation focus, their focus is on one or few products, differentiating those products. That is what differentiation focus is all about. Then differentiation leadership. Now, this is the broader term. Now, they'll differentiate completely. This strategy involves selecting one or more criteria used by buyers in a market and then positioning the business uniquely to meet those criteria. This strategy is usually associated with charging a premium price for the product, often to reflect the higher production costs and extra value added feature provided for the consumer. There are several ways in which this can be achieved, though it is not easy and it requires substantial and sustained marketing investment. The methods include superior product quality, features, benefits, durability, reliability, and on. Then branding, strong customer recognition and desire, the brand loyalty. Then industry-wide distribution across all major channels. The product or brand is an essential item to be stocked by retailers. So consistent promotional support, often dominated by advertising, sponsorships, etc. And what are the great examples of differentiation leadership? It includes global brands like Nike and Mercedes. These brands achieve significant economies of scale, but they do not rely on cost leadership strategy to compete. Their business and brands are built on persuading customers to become brand loyal and paying a premium for their products. Like, for example, in diamonds, De Beers. So, you know, they have that niche market with them. Tiffany's is another, market, or Louis Vuitton for that matter, for handbags. Now, these are niche markets. They will not come into cost leadership because they want their product to be differentiated. They want their brand to be differentiated. Now, if you see what is the difference between the differentiation leadership and differentiation focus, is that differentiation leadership, in differentiation leadership, the entire company is having that niche brand, whereas in case of differentiation focus, let us take example of Lux. So Lux has got a very cheap soap as well as the higher to cater to the high-end customers, in which the Shah Rukh Khan is lying in the bathtub with the rose petals. So they have a differentiation focus there. But differentiation leadership is when all throughout you are serving all your products, your business line, everything is a little niche. So this is what differentiation leadership is all about. Porter said that all these strategies are going to make a difference. A firm can have either of these four strategies to deal with the competition or the competitive environment in which the business is working. Thank you very much for listening.